It's June 30th, 2012, and I've just loaded a shiny new Cyanogenmod 9 alpha build onto my shiny new HTC One X. This is the North American version, not the international version, so it uses the Snapdragon processor as opposed to the NVIDIA Tegra 3. So it was actually a little more challenging to find a ROM for it. But thanks to VinVinVinster, whose build I found on the xda-developers.com forums, I'm now running it on my device. So this is my first time ever modding my phone, so to say I was nervous about loading a custom, non-manufacturer-approved ROM onto the device is quite an understatement. I was terrified of turning my shiny new device into a brick. But no tragedies occurred, and here we are. I've been running it for about 12 hours now, and so far it's been a pretty good experience. So I'd just like to take a bit of time to show a couple of the features that I found in Cyanogenmod that I found particularly useful. And the first one is this concept of profiles. So if you go into settings, there's the profiles section, which, and it ends up being fairly reminiscent to what I used to use for many years on BlackBerry. So I've set up my home, night, silent, work, various profiles, and so that you can set up your device to behave differently in different situations. So you can control things such as turning on or off or leaving alone the state of certain radios, Bluetooth, GPS, Wi-Fi. You can set the volumes, so while I'm at home I don't mind media, ringtones, and everything being loud, whereas at work I like to turn down those volumes. You can control specific applications, and these groups are entirely customizable. But even cooler is the lock screen mode. So while I'm at home, I'm not too afraid of people stealing my device or stealing my information, so I like to have it more convenient in an insecure, or actually let's make it completely disabled mode. So there's no lock screen whatsoever when I'm in home mode. And when I switch to work, then obviously I'll turn, or if anytime I go out of the house, I like to turn on the lock screen just in case the device goes missing on me. So this is one option in order to change profiles, is to go into the settings app and choose the profile that you would like. But that's a little bit inconvenient, especially if you're moving around a lot. So if you press and hold the power key, there's an option here to change the profile. So if I click here, it gives me a list of the profiles and I can easily switch between the different ones. Also, you may have noticed on the screen, there's the option to take a screenshot right from the power screen. Very cool. Another feature that I really like about Cyanogenmod is the menu key. That's right, I said the menu key. On the HTC One X, you get a back button, a home button, and a task switcher button. Google has tried to deprecate the whole idea of a menu button, much to the Samsung Galaxy S3's chagrin, as they've included a menu button, despite that advice. But I personally like the menu button because it's an operation I use quite frequently. Often you'll see the menu button all over the place. Sometimes it's up here in the corner, sometimes it's down here in the corner, sometimes it's all the way across the bottom. But after loading Cyanogenmod 9, there's actually a secret button beside the task switcher button. So if I click here on the task switcher, here we are in the task switcher. But if I click a little bit to the right of it, yes, there's actually a distinct hidden button to the right of the task switcher button, which will bring up the menu. Very handy. And I think one of the reasons that I wanted Cyanogenmod the most is because for some reason at HTC they turned off one of the coolest features. And it's the feature that when you hit the power button, it turns off like an old-fashioned 60s TV. Pew! Love it. And that feature alone was enough to convince me to load this mod onto there. Everything I've tried is working so far. All the apps that you see on the screen, I've at least given them cursory tests. The phone works, sending, receiving messages. I have a pair of Bluetooth headphones which work really well. The only thing that doesn't really live up to the way Sense was before is the camera. So the camera app, this is more or less stock ice cream sandwich. And it just, you know, HTC did an awesome job on the camera on this phone. And so to use the built-in camera app, it's just a major step backwards. Hopefully in the future, that will be fixed. But you know what? I'm just thankful that I have a build at all. Like the camera, it doesn't even use the entire screen real estate. It's like it's not using the whole camera. If you bring up the photo, it only takes up about this part, this much of the screen. So just before I let you go, I'll just make sure to show you the version that I'm actually running on here. So as you can see, model number, Android version 404. And here we go, Cyanogenmod version 9, built on June 24th, 2012. It's an unofficial build. Actually, it was built on June 23rd, so it's only a few days old, but it's running very well for me on this phone. And I hope you give it a try. If you're scared to mod your phone, it's actually not that bad.